Hello, and welcome back to Hard Water Channel. This is round three of the test drive challenge on the Nürburgring. Sunday morning out here in Calgary, Alberta. Nuts. I haven't done that in a long time. So I think it said the engine damage is about 15%. So that being under 20%, that's okay. This is my first lap of the day. I've had one cup of coffee. So this is my warm-up lap here. Still not very prideful of it. Oh no. Now we're at 15% clutch damage and 14% engine damage. Still within game rule limits, which is 20%, but not very happy. Thank you. a lot of power. Damage. Suspension damage, 36% engine damage, 37% clutch damage. So it's pit stop time. So the object is to only pit four tires alone. After about three laps, we're going to be down to about 73% tire wear, at which point we're going to begin losing grip. So if we can get around without as much as 20% damage on any component, and we only need to pit for tire change alone, then we've passed the challenge. But at this point, we gotta start over from zero damage. That's a nicer start than last lap. That was a pretty terrible first lap, to be honest. cigarettes. I think I need another coffee, guys. Showing off now. no. Oh, I've totally wrecked it now. Just destroyed the car on this lap. Well, not as bad as the previous lap, but still, that was pretty bad. 23% damage, forcing me back into the pit. Now I got some front end damage, which makes me look crap. I am a pretty bad driver, eh, guys? Come on. Just look what I did to this car already. I should like a clean car for a nice clean lap. I don't think it's gonna go that way.
Hooray!
acceptable. Nuts. Boy, I'm doing awful today. It's from watching all you guys playing yesterday. What were you, racing minis around here? Rear-wheel drive minis spinning out like crazy cars. Times in one lap in my memory. Except when I was driving the Corvette around here. That was stupid. I mean, Corvette's a nice car and everything, but it's not meant for this sort of driving. Corvettes for showing off to your mates in the middle of town, you know, doing burnouts in the parking lot. It's not for racing the Nürburgring. You need actual grip. Got this beautiful Corvette C6. Oh my goodness. 360 miles per hour, yeah? If you just turn slightly over, you're going off the track. Like, it's like trying to ride on the top of a pin. But if you could do it, you'd go like snot. But that rear wheel drive just will not stay stable. And I've been raised in Canada for a long time, and I have to say we're pretty used to the rear-wheel drive out here because of the long flat roads. You don't need front-wheel drive like you do in Europe. So you get the Americans out there on tracks like this, and they just lose it. They have to practice it so much. Do yourselves a favor, lads. Just get a front-wheel drive. Now, do we have to pit quickly? No. I'm glad we don't have to pit, because that would have been a fail. Three pits, and not one of them for an official tire change. So, that's not good. To two pits at this point, still pretty bad. Let me know if you'd like me to just keep driving. If the damage is 20% or more, instead of pitting, just keep driving until the car dies. And pit only for tires alone, no matter what. Or continue to do it this way, where if the damage is under 20%, we don't count it, and if it's over 20%, we're gonna pit and just go until we do have to just do the tires. So let me know in the comment what you decide. Because in this game, we don't have time of day, weather, fuel level. The only thing we have is tires and damage to the vehicle. There's no wind. Now, if you would like to see with the wind and fog, we can put some San Francisco Rush on for you. It's less of an accurate game, but it's a fun game. It's definitely fun. I really enjoy San Francisco Rush 2 because it's just got fun tracks. Whoops. Oh no. No, I've damaged my clutch here. Too busy talking and I've gone and damaged my clutch. If I could just get one clean lap, I'd be happy. I just lost at this game. aggressive person by nature. Really. On the engine and 25% on the clutch. What do you say? Should I pit because of that 6% over? And what's my tires like? My tires are at 50%. I'm gonna not pit. Because pitting now seems like, oh goodness, I gotta do another 3 laps. I'm thinking of moving the damage limit up to 25% maybe. For once this round. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. don't sound good. Uh-oh. What did I do? Holy cow. I wrecked it. In the first quarter. Limp this thing all the way back to the pits. Oh dear me. I've just been doing fantastic drives, so I thought I'm gonna video them. And as soon as I did that, this is the sort of drive I get. Driving your car or this one. Considering how badly it's damaged, I think the other cars would be doing about exactly 41 miles per hour. You know how I know that? Because of my first gear. Nothing works. Nothing works. Come on, you can do it. If I make it to the pit. Well, it's not like I can really crash it very well. Thank you. Well, now we've really caked it. Now, believe it or not, I have had a worse damaged car than this, and still made it back to the pit. However, the engine wasn't quite this damaged. Oh, come on. Come on. This is the highest point. Come on. It's all downhill from here. Nothing negative intended there. Come on. Come on. Come on. Now tell me if your car were damaged like this, if it could even move. Well, we're in the final quarter, and I think it's gonna, if this were a race, I'd be lapped about 3 times already. Absolute fail. Third gear's on. It's like, hooray. Enduro rally racing, you might say, boy, this is like boring to watch. You know what, this is the event, trying to get back to the pit. How crazy can you build your car, how badly can you smash it, and still make it back to the pit? Can you, or are you gonna get stuck in the sand over here? I've got about a half a horsepower right now. Last hill. Come on. Well, second to last hill. Come on, pit road. And if you're that loyal that you've stayed on the video this long, thank you very much. And please put an asterisk in your comment if you've watched it to the end here. And if you're a subscriber to this channel, please put a checkered flag in your comment. And please comment if you'd like to adjust the pit rules. Because I will cater to, you know, if you ask me something, I will cater to that to the best of my ability. So, what I'm going to be coming up with is much better quality driving than you've been seeing, because this is obviously not my best. And I'm going to be doing some other game casts. What do you all think about original Nintendo? Pretty crap, eh? But, I mean, there was a lot of fun games, and I'm going to play the most fun game that I've ever played on basic Nintendo, Solar Jetman. We like our Kerbal Space Program, which is the newest rendition of this. This is about the second or third rendition of such a planetary exploration game where you have a rocket-powered jet pod. But I think this is my favorite one from that era by TradeWest Rare Games. And there's 13 planets. Actually, there's really 12. There's like 12 in the game, and then there's a bonus 13th planet that you have to get to by a special warp. And you can also put in codes like you used to be able to do on a lot of Nintendo games. And you can get to secret places using codes. So that's what I'm going to be playing for you next. And I'm not going to be posting any more of these videos where I just totally wreck the car, because I don't think you guys really want to watch that. I thought you did. But I'm seeing that you don't find this the most entertaining thing. But here I am. 79% front tire wear, and wow, 79% brake damage, 88% engine damage, 88% suspension damage, 42% steering damage, 67% clutch damage, and further damage. So we're gonna call that a fail, and thanks for being with us this far. We'll see you in the next video.